competition to build the latest generation fighter aircraft. In 2024, the stakes couldn't be higher for the Air Force as they need to decide who will build the sixth generation NGAD fighter aircraft. This marvel represents a turning point in fighter aircraft design and the ability of the US Air Force to maintain its unmatched air superiority. The contest has come down to two aerospace titans, Lockheed versus Boeing, and whoever wins could shape the future of each company. However, this project is so shrouded in mystery that it's akin to the modern aviation's Area 51. Using these two concept models, we will delve deeper into this competition. After years of development, our story began last May when the Air Force challenged a contractor to finalize and build a clean sheet design of an aircraft so advanced that it's set to surpass the legendary F-22 Raptor. This isn't just another fighter jet, it's a generational leap into the future with an aggressive timeline aiming for production lines by the end of this decade. However, NGAD isn't just a single aircraft, it's an entire family of systems, a master and its fleet of drone wingmen known as collaborative combat aircraft. More on that later, as we unravel the secrets, rivalries, and groundbreaking advancements of the edgy project. Also, there's more at stake than just an airframe design. We'll also look at how the competition to build the advanced engine which will power the NGAD is just starting to heat up, along with other related components. But before I reveal my predictions, we also have to take a look at other critical components of the NGAD program, such as the engines. The NGAD contract will also involve an all-new and revolutionary power plant known as an adaptive cycle engine. This power plant is a sophisticated type of jet engine designed to provide high performance across a wide range of speeds and altitudes. When it comes to engines, we've come down to two manufacturers, Pratt & Whitney and General Electric. Pratt & Whitney bring a proven track record and innovative technologies, while General Electric offers advanced engine technology and robust R&D capabilities. Each company brings its own distinct advantage to the table, and the decision will ultimately hinge on what set of strengths and weaknesses aligns best with the Air Force's vision of the NGAD program. These are my predictions, but they could be way off. Let me know your thoughts, predictions, and reasoning in the comments below. That's it for today's episode. If you enjoyed this analysis and want to stay updated on the latest in military aviation, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Stay tuned for more content, and as always, keep looking to the skies.